And according to research, that this informal, look, informal economy where the townships are, it actually competes with the formal, what the formal don. That's why your big companies such as your ShopRite, your Pick and Pay, that's why they wanna.
Ever noted, ShopRite operates, I'm talking about the ShopRite group, right? Operates as ShopRite in black people predominated areas, yet it operates as Checkers in middle class or well off areas.
Yes.
Are you telling me that should we trust the quality of food? We talked about the well-being, right? Should we trust the quality of food on the shelves since it is offered at those low prices?
But the Simbas that you buy in Checkers with the taste of the one in ShopRite,
okay,
it's different
okay.
In any way. So it's just some things that we want to bring up. But being honest, it's a Simba, the different results that Checkers ShopRite.
And
okay,
you know,
all right, right.
You put out insults as to can this food really be entrusted, looking at the prices. You also have to look at the fact that they have been approved by the Department of Health and by the Department of Trade and Industry and by the Department of Agriculture, Forestry and Fisheries.
How do you justify that black people are poor? I mean, listen to this one. According to an article released by E! Daily Investor on the 8th of July, 2024 by Sean Jacobs. In that article, it was reported that the South African informal business account for, or does that business alone, it's worth R750 billion. Now, you will remember on a previous episode, or in one of the episodes, I did mention the fact that out of that 750 billion, Spaza shops alone account for, it accounts for something around close to 200 billion. But in Jay, all the informal thing, now you understand if I bring the issue of Spaza shop, that we are really talking about something informal here. That informal business, it accounts for 750 billion. No wonder ShopRite wants to penetrate that space. No wonder Pick and Pay wants to penetrate that space. Pick and Pay has got something called Boxer. They are coming up with something to compete in that space. ShopRite has got YouSave, everything. Hey, they must be greedy, those guys. Yo, they want everything, guys.
Well, you know, I have to object with your last statement as to they must be greedy. When we look at the stats in South Africa, also during looking at the report compiled by ShopRite, it also states that ShopRite is the largest private sector employer in South Africa. In the it is important figure to the employment growth within the nation. Now, when we look at a report that they also did in 2023, it states that in 2023, ShopRite compiled a report stating that they added, listen to this, they added 8,131 new jobs, bringing the total number of employed individuals by the group to 153,726.
Hmm.
So now, we can see the importance of these when you're saying that they are...
Granted objection.
All right.
Okay.
I hear you giving the stats, nice and everything and all that, but I have a biggest question to whatever that you just mentioned right now. Why is it ShopRite Group are always located in black people predominated areas country-wise?
Well,
let me indulge in this one.
Okay.
Let me indulge in this one. Right. Why what?
Why is it that we have ShopRite operating in black people
most okay
areas, so
now
areas?
It's a when you look at it in a right perspective, ShopRite presents a chance for black people to be able to afford things at a lower price, firstly. And it provides a chance for black people to have more employment. As I was saying, from where I was reading, I got that there at least ShopRite has 1,600 employers. So it presents a chance for black people to do the right, to have employees yes. and who can also have access of food closely and cut short yes. the
expense. I object.
Well,
noted. Now, guys, here's the problem that I'm facing. You know, I went back now to the article and listened to the article. And I'm going to repeat. The article was written by Ushon Jacobs, released on the 8th of July, 2024. And it speaks about this, right? That the informal economy, in that informal economy, you're talking about spaza shops, all things along those lines, right? It has got a net worth of 750 billion. So if you are saying 750 billion, it's actually found, according to research, that this informal economy where the townships are, it actually competes with the formal don. That's why your big companies such as your ShopRite, your Pick and Pay, that's why they want to go there. In fact, let me tell you this, right? As of now, me speaking to you, somewhere in Vets, they are working on, there's a department there that is doing a research. Yeah. They are trying to penetrate that market. So big companies are doing research there, and all of them are saying that there's money in the township with billions and billions, but they are struggling to follow the cash. They know there's cash in the townships, right? So no wonder these ones are getting jealous. What are you saying?
Well, you know what I have to say about this is that, yes, that may be the case. You know, there's a lot of money circulating within that. But we also have to realize that why is ShopRite located in predominantly black locations is that majority of the times, these communities are located at a far distance from the retail. So what ShopRite has done is to ensure that they go into the doorsteps of these individuals in the stores, also through creating what they now call Ekasi stores. Now, in a report compiled by ShopRite, if I may read it to you,
yes,
it says that the communities we serve always at the core of our business, and our CSI strategic and social investment initiative are aligned with our purpose, values, and our priority to be a force for good. We promote the well-being, safety, and sustainability of our communities and seek ways to address their needs by pioneering across to affordable goods and services and creating economic opportunities.
The word I noted is the well-being of Don Don, product that promotes the well-being of Don Don.
Yeah. Can I come in on that one? I hear you, my brother. You're talking about the well-being of people. And I also noted the fact and the point that you mentioned about affordable. Now, here's my biggest question. If you've ever noted, ShopRite operates, I'm talking about the ShopRite group, right? Operates as ShopRite in black people predominated areas. Yet it operates as Checkers in middle class or well-off areas.
Yes.
Are you telling me that should we trust the quality of food? We talked about the well-being, right? Should we trust the quality of food on the shelves since it is offered at those low prices?
Yes, yes.
Are those, should we really, really trust the quality because of those? At whose expense are we trusting the low qualities? And tell me, why is it operating as ShopRite in black people community and Checkers in another different community as well?
In other words, you are saying it can't be that it could be that even their packaging and the type of food, the quality of food that is served for a certain class, it at a certain level,
exactly,
and for a certain
point.
Class, it is at a certain level.
Yes.
Exactly.
Maybe you are questioning the healthiness of the food.
I have to object.
Okay, objection will be granted.
Yes,
but
I have to object.
Come in.
She can't really prove what she's saying, you know, because if I'm getting her point correctly, she's basically saying that the things that are sold in ShopRite, with quality, they are a bit lower compared to the one in Checkers. But then she can't really prove that the Simbas that you buy in Checkers with the taste of the one in ShopRite
is different
in any way. So it's just some things that we want to bring up, but
yes.
Being honest, it's a Simba, the difference is just that Checkers ShopRite.
Okay, you know,
fine, continue.
You know, these prices, definitely they can be trusted because they ensure that grandma and child headed families go to bed on a full stomach. Now, before you put out insults as to can these foods really be entrusted, looking at the prices, you also have to look at the fact that they have been approved by the Department of Health and by the Department of Trade and Industry and by the Department of Agriculture, Forestry and Fisheries. Now, to answer you as to why is there a difference in the middle class Shoprite operating as Checkers as well. Shoprite, their main initiative is to ensure that the communities are provided with affordable goods. Now, when you look at enterprises like Checkers and all these other retailers, they give you an option of which people in the lower class do not have an option. Mm-hmm. Now, what Shoprite has done is to bring the essential goods that are needed by people on a day-to-day basis.
I object. Yes.
Granted.
I truly object on that one. Have you ever realized that when you go into Checkers, there are some products that are sold in Checkers, but you don't find them in Shoprite? What does that mean?
Objection.
If they claim to be of the same group and they are yet selling products that you find in Checkers, but you don't find it in Shoprite, that's where I'm questioning the quality of the food Shoprite is selling.
Okay, noted, but come in.
That's very simple. It's about the survey. They just check us to...
Okay.
How the people around the environment.
So you are saying they did a survey on affordability.
Yes. Simple. And now if we go back to the stats, Shoprite rates number 2 as the best selling retailers. And even the quality of their food, people when they rank the thing, they are getting at least 4 out of 5 with the ranking.
Point of correction there.
I'm coming. Continue.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. So I don't think that they have any shaky thing when it comes
really
to the quality of the food. There's nothing shaky. If people are able to can say out of 5, you get a 4. That's a distinction, right?
Okay. But wait, guys. Giving you this information free and fair, yet people are not subscribed. Come on, guys. This information is provided free.
If you're busy filtering your life right now, subscribe.
Hit us with some like there. Unfiltered debate. When you don't like, just unlike.
And make sure that you engage in the comment section and do what you do best. Share with your friends and families.
Because we are unfiltered debate. Nevertheless, let me grant you. You can speak.
Okay, my brother here. You raised a very important fact here. You said they survey. Oh my goodness. Yo, that just really touched me deep. Let me stand up.
Okay.
What's the problem?
Like we talked about black people being said that it's a poor, like we are poor and everything. And now you are saying
we have to object on that one.
They made a survey again.
Noted.
Let me come to my point.
I'll make sure they don't speak before you talk.
It seems like Shoprite has made a very good revenue coming from black people, yet the quality of food, you are telling me that after that survey, if they are making a good revenue out of those black community area, he talked about some billions that's coming out of those locally,
the Kasi stores,
and Shoprite is also moving
let me give you the states. It's actually 180 billion annually. So that means as Spaza Shop, when you say Spaza Shop, just know that Spaza Shop that you are seeing, when you combine it just throughout South Africa, the money that is flowing out of that Spaza Shop combined, it's 180 billion annually.
Yes, continuing from that, my point is that if so much money is coming out of that black community so-called area, those billions, and then at the same time, Shoprite is saying that after this survey, we don't think that they can afford products that you find in Checkers. Mm-hmm. That's utterly rubbish. It doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense at all. Okay. That's why I'm going back to the quality of food. Can we really trust those low prices?
Okay, granted. Yes. Objection granted.
What Usisu Charmaine here is missing is that Shoprite, not only is making revenues, but it is contributing as it is the largest employer in the private sector with a large number of over 100,000. Now, when you're saying that they do not care rather about the communities, they offer, this is their main goal, this is the main target, that they are focused on the hunger relief programs and food security, youth unemployment, and enterprise supplier development. When we now come take it home, like bringing it home closer, we get to look at the established Mofire brand with DJ Spoo. ShopRite has given him that platform to actually say, you know what, we will now sell your product and give it to a larger scale of consumers, you know. So it gives out opportunities. How can you say that they are only in this for making revenues?
It's absolutely obvious that they are not only here for the revenues. ShopRite, it's actually doing a great thing. Firstly, it gives out employment to people. It feeds people in a way that, like you're saying, when ShopRite, the aim of ShopRite is to make sure that at least each and everyone, you know, they check the classes, they make sure each and everyone, when you get there, they make sure that even that person who has like 200, at least spend it there. You know, they're not only aiming for the people who has 1,000, they're aiming for that 10 rand that you have. Get a bread there.
Even the 5.
That's not right for you.
That is very interesting because I happened to look at a chart. I had a chart with the person who is working in this management of this brand. Yeah, I'm not going to say him, but it's a supermarket, so well-established ones. So this person told me, good, listen. She was like, listen, you know, have you ever asked yourself a question? Why, when you look at your Pick and Pays, your ShopRite, your Checkers in your middle class income earners, you'll never find sugar for 5 rand, 10 rand. But when you go to Ekas, where people are, they sat down and they discussed that, no man, here we've got clients who've got 200 rand. We must make sure that when they enter our store, they have a sugar, they have a mili-mili, but all those things are packaged in small and in a package, which makes it, well, at the end of the
questionable.
Day, at some point, if you don't know, ShopRite has been declared as one of the a company in South Africa, supermarket that has got the most money. At some point, it just said that they have enough money that they can buy Pick and Pay world, countrywide cash. That's how much money there. But if you're looking at where they are operating, you're like, you are operating in a township area, yet you make more money than Pick and Pay predominantly. Not that they are not found in local black areas.
Well,
but predominantly, they are found in their target has always been upper class income earners.
Well, one thing that we can most definitely say and agree with is that when you look at the market that ShopRite has targeted, they have ensured that each and every single person is at least counted in their range. When you look at having a decision for those people who would like to seem fancy and buy their brand instead, because brands nowadays make people comfortable, hence why people want to buy expensive, because expensive validates that it is what? A good product. Now, what ShopRite has done, it has ensured that through their hunger relief programs, everyone goes to bed on a full stomach. I think that is one of the most global fights that we are facing today, especially in this continent of ours. When you look at the perception that the West has on Africans, it's usually linking towards hunger. So now when we look at ShopRite, ShopRite ensures we do not run in that very same race that we are linked with.
The question that I hear what you're saying, I want to give you. The question that have to be asked with what you are saying.
Yes.
I know you'll answer it after him. But the question that you have to ask is, yes, I see that you are saying they are on, they are in pursuit of ending poverty, yes. Right? So that's why they structure. But the question is, maybe we need to do a research on the quality of the food that they produce, but it's fine.
Okay. Before I had forgotten this, I want you to reflect back on the point that you mentioned about opportunities that ShopRite actually offers, and also employment rate, that it has employed a lot of families, and it is providing for them, right, generally. Mm-hmm. So my question there is how much is a ShopRite employee, how much is a ShopRite employee earning, and how much is grocery in ShopRite? Yes, it seems like it's offering low prices, those basics and everything, but I'm telling you, their own employee gets to spend the whole salary just on food itself. So are you telling me, I'm not going to mention somebody else's salary,
but I have done my research on that one.
That is such a small amount, yet they claim to fight against poverty.
Wait,
that was my first point. And the second point.
Before you get into the second point.
Okay.
Okay. So what I'm hearing is that you are questioning this thing, which we have seen with companies. They tend to be more concerned about their public image, less concerned about quality. The people who are working in the very same company. So we are saying that it could be that yes, they are producing proper food, they are catering for those people, but at the expense of their own workers. Well, that is what I'm hearing, right?
I'm not yet agreeing with that one.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, your last point is that you are saying it could be that they are more concerned about producing this type of food and doing all of this at the expense of their own workers. They are not paying them enough.
Exactly.
But yes, they are ending hunger. That's what I'm hearing. Yes, they might be ending hunger out there, but inside, their employees are crying. But wait a minute. We'll come back on part two, right? It's going to be interesting again. We need to finish up because I will need to quote you something, right? Where it has been said that ShopRite strategically wanted a share of the money that you black people have in the township. And Pick and Pay said, no. Ungashinga phandle. Nathi siyafuna leyo mali. So the Pick and Pay yangena nayo. Yangena phaka. So in this episode, let's end it here with the hope that part two is coming anytime soon from now.